Hi, it's Kiffin Lobates here, and this is a follow-up video to the one I made a few days ago concerning the OpenDAO, the SOS token, and the risks of engaging with Web3 websites and with token drops. So SOS, it seems to be doing okay at the moment. Who knows whether it's going to go up or down, but there are a few extra things that have come to light over the last few days. For starters, I've had another look at the contract and I can't see an obvious way that the contract deployers could steal assets from your Ethereum wallet. So that's a positive, although as someone pointed out on the previous video, I think it was Olivier, if you are serious about buying and selling digital assets, then you should have a wallet for contract interaction and then you should have another holding wallet. So if you buy a token or if you participate in an airdrop, you should be using what is effectively a throwaway wallet, and then after you have the assets you should transfer them out into a safe second address. That way there's no direct link between the contract that you interacted with and your address, and that should protect you against any kind of nefarious or sneaky underhand methods for draining your wallet. The downside to that, of course, is that it involves extra transaction fees, and these can get pretty high pretty quickly if what you're working on is mainly Ethereum. But anyway, back to the SOS token drop and the contract associated with it. So some people have gone and looked at the signing part in more detail. Again, it doesn't seem to be set up in such a way that it can steal your private keys or your assets. However, the observation has been made that the deployers of the contract can create arbitrary signatures in order to, in quotes, claim the airdrop tokens. And therefore, when you see a wallet with a balance of SOS tokens, you don't actually know whether they got it because of their activity on OpenSea or whether the contract deployers actually are in cahoots with them and have basically given them a free handout. Now, some people seem concerned about this. I'm not so concerned about it because I have a bigger worry, which is the observation that half the tokens are currently sitting in three wallets. So that means that there's an immense amount of centralization and the rug could be pulled on this at any time by those wallet holders using their vast number of SOS tokens in order to drain all the liquidity out of the decentralized exchanges that are being used in order to exchange the SOS token with Ether or some other crypto token. And that is a real worry. This is a classic way of conducting one of these scams. You build up interest in the project, people start buying the tokens for something like Ether, which has recognized market value, and now you have a decentralized exchange that has a lot of Ether in it and a little bit of the token that's being traded, and then the whales come in and basically dump all their holdings of that token, thereby draining out all the ether. The price of the token plummets and all the people who bought the token with real money, I'm calling ether real money here, I'm aware of that, find that effectively what has happened is wealth has gone from their wallets into the wallets of the whales who issued the token in the first place. So that's a genuine concern. Half the tokens are in the hands of the anonymous project owners. Of course, the flip side to that is that most people who are participating in the trading and transferring of SOS tokens got them all free in the first place. So you could argue that as long as you haven't actually spent any of your own money, you're not going to make a loss. You just might fail to make a profit if you don't get out at the right time, i.e. before the big whales dump their stuff. And of course, the final proviso is that we don't know if those three big whales are actually in this as a pump and dump scheme, or if they are genuinely passionate about building a decentralized version of OpenSea. Really, as is surprisingly often the case in DeFi and blockchain projects, although these systems are meant to be trustless, they're meant to remove the requirement for you to trust people because you can just go look at the code and see what's going on. In practice, we still find that human element of trust creeping in. If you trust the people behind the OpenDAO project and you believe that they are passionate about building a decentralized NFT marketplace to rival OpenSea, then everything should be well and good if that trust is well placed. However, if you don't trust them, then probably worth avoiding, or maybe the best compromise is to set up a new wallet, transfer all your assets that you bought on OpenSea out to that new wallet, and then go and claim your SOS token on the wallet that did all the original trading on OpenSea, so you get your token allocation. As is always the case in DeFi, it's really up to you to make the call. I'm just here to try and help you understand a bit better what is going on here, so you have all the facts before you make a decision. Anyway, that's it for today. I think that probably wraps up the OpenDAO and SOS token topic. So I'll be moving on to other things in the next few days. Bye for now.